गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर बेरोड एस टी फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ पार्शियल पिवोटिंग मेथड फ्रॉम यूनिट नंबर 2, दैट इज साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशंस. सो आई विल जस्ट राइट डाउन द न्यूमेरिकल. Is solve the following systems of equation by Gauss elimination method use partial pivoting. The set of equations are 0 x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 is equal to 5. x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3 is equal to 11. Minus 3x1 plus x2 minus 5x3 is equal to minus 12. So students, set of equations are given here. Partial pivoting, you just write down these equations are in the form of Ax equal to b, that is in the form of matrix. Here coefficient of x1 is 0, here it is 1 2 1 2 4, minus 3 1 minus 5 into x1 x2 x3 is equal to 5, 11, minus 12. So students, partial pivoting means here in this case the diagonal element here for row 1 diagonal element is 0. Again for row 2 diagonal element is 2 and for row 3 diagonal element is minus 5. So what is partial pivoting, students? Partial pivoting is nothing but the diagonal elements, these 0 to minus 5, these are the diagonal elements of matrix, should have maximum absolute value. That is called as, or that is the condition of partial pivoting. So students, in this case for row 1, this 0, first diagonal element 0, it should be maximum value, means the value should be either 1 or greater than 1, that is any absolute value should be on the row 1 diagonal element. So how to convert that 0 into absolute value? By rearranging the rows. So here in this case we just rearrange the row 1 as R1 as R3, because R3, for R3 this minus 3 means here this minus 3 is absolute value and 0 is non absolute value, means it is 0. So we just rearrange the rows R1 as R3. So by rearranging we'll get minus 3, 1, minus 5, R2 is same or as it is 1, 2, 4, 0, 1, 2 into x1, x2, x3 is equal to, here R1 as R3 means we rearrange the terms R1 as R3, that is minus 12, 11, 5. we interchange the rows R1 and R3. So next step, we know that in Gauss elimination method we have to convert this matrix into upper triangular form. Upper triangular form means what? We have to convert this triangle into zero, so that we'll get answer for first unknown x3, because here we use backward substitution method. So next step, what is next step? We have to convert this minus 3 into 1. How to convert? Perform operation on row 1 as R1 divided by minus 3. So by dividing minus 3 by 2 minus 3, we will get 1. Here 1 upon minus 3, it is 1 upon minus 3 is minus 0.33. minus 5 upon minus 3, it is 1.66. row 2 is as it is 12012 into x1, x2, x3 is equal to R1. Here minus 12 upon minus 3, that is 4115. So here we convert this one first row 1 element into 1. So next step, we have to convert this 1 into 0. How to convert? Perform operation. Which operation? Second, perform operation R2 on row 2 as R2 minus R1. We have to subtract this 1 minus 1, we'll get here 0. 2 minus this, 4 minus this, and 11 minus 4. So next step, we have to perform operation on row 2, that is R2 minus R1. So by performing operation on row 2, that is matrix is 1 minus 0.33, 1.66, row 1, we'll take this as it is. Then perform operation on row 2, that is R2 minus R1, that is here it is 0 and here 2.33, here 2.34. why 2.33? because in previous step, that is here it is 2 minus of minus 0.33, it is 2.33, and in this case here it is 4 minus 1.66, that is 2.34, and here 0 1 2. Third row is as it is, x1 x2 x3 is equal to R2. In previous step R2 is 11, so 4, 11 minus 4 is 7 5. So in this way we'll perform operation on row number 2. Next step, here we convert these two elements 0 0, and remaining element is this 1. We have to convert this 1 into 0. How to convert this 1 into 0? Before that, we have to perform operation on row 2, because we have to convert this 2.33 into 1. How to convert? We have to just divide this row number 2 divided by 2.33. Means we get 1 minus 0.33, 1.660, 0. Divide this 2.33 to 2.33, will get 1. 2.34 or 2.33 upon 2.33 is 1. Here it is 0 1 2 into x1 x2 x3 is equal to R2 upon 2.33, it is 4 3 5. So by dividing this 7 by 2.33, we'll get answer as 3. So next step, you have to convert this 1 into 0, because in Gauss elimination method we have to convert this matrix into upper triangular form. Means here I want this 1 as a 0. So how to convert? By performing operation R3, that is on row number 3, that is R3 minus R2. So 1 minus 0.33, 1.66, 0, 1, 1. Here it is R3 minus R2, 0 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 1, 1. Into x1, x2, x3 is equal to R3 minus R2, that is 4, 3, this 5 minus 3 is 2. Here, in this way, we have to convert this matrix into upper triangular form, that is here 0, 0 and 0 means these are the diagonal element. Below diagonal element, will convert the element into 0, that is in upper triangular form. Next step, what is next step? Use backward substitution method. What is backward substitution method? We know that here find unknown x3. How to find an unknown x3? We know that this x3, 1 into x3 is equal to 2, means x3 unknown is equal to 2. We'll get first unknown x3, that is equal to 2. Then how to find x2? We know that perform or write down equation 1 into x2 plus 1 into x3. This 0 into x1 means 0. 1 into x2 plus 1 into x3 is equal to 3. Means x2 plus 1 into x3 is 2, that is equal to 3. Means x2 equal to 3 minus 2, that is x2 equal to 1. Means we'll get answer for x3 and x2, that is x3 is 2 and x1 is 1. Then next, how to find x1? We know that, or just write down equation, this 1 into x1 minus 5 minus, because your sign is minus 0.33 into x2 plus 5 plus, because it, here it is plus 1.66 into x3, that is equal to 4. So we know that x1 minus 0.33 into x2 is 1 plus 1.66 into x3 is 2, that is equal to 4. So by calculation we'll get this x1, this term is 2.99 is equal to 4, means this x1 is equal to 4 minus 2.99. this 2.99 approximately equal to 3, means x1 is equal to 4 minus 3 is 1. So we'll get final answer x1 equal to 1. And finally we'll get the answer as x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 1 and x3 equal to 2. These are the unknowns. So this method is nothing but Gauss elimination method with partial pivoting. Thank you.